Welcome back to the next session of sets, relations and functions. Now let me introduce the concept of function today. Now let us say a relation like this, y is equal to f of x. There are two variables under consideration, y and variable x. Now the variable what you are writing on the right hand side is an independent variable. And the variable what you are writing on the left hand side is a dependent variable. Now I am supplying independent values to the independent variable. Corresponding to each input, I will get an output for the dependent variable. If there exists such type of relation between the two variables, then it is called a functional relationship between the two variables. Let's see an example here. Total cost, let us take this is y is equal to 10x plus 500. Cost function, a linear cost function is considered, a linear cost function is taken. Now let us see here, this 10x is variable cost, this 500 is fixed cost. 10x is variable cost and 500 is fixed cost. Let us take x is equal to 1, then you will get y is equal to 510. When x is equal to 2, y is equal to 1, 510. When x is equal to 2, 520. When x is equal to 3, 530. When x is equal to 4, y value 500. Corresponding to each input to an independent variable, you are getting a corresponding output for the dependent variable. This is called a functional relationship between two variables x and y. Now, cost is a function. Cost function. It is a function in output. How can you read it? It is a function, cost function, which consists of variable cost and fixed cost. This way, if you write explicitly dependent variable on the left hand side, independent variable on the right hand side, then it is called a functional relationship and this is function. Basic definition of function, input and output relation. When there exists an input and output relation, it is called a function. So the values you are supplying to the independent variable is called domain. Domain means values of independent variable, values of independent variable is domain, range, values of dependent variable, values of dependent variable. This way there are two variables we have and this way relation you define. Okay, let us see some numerical problems based on this one. After that we will go for application of this. Let us see first question. F of x is equal to x plus 1 divided by x square minus 3x minus 4. Find f of 0, f of 1, f of minus 1. F of 0, f of 1, f of minus 1. What does this f of 0 stands for? Replace the independent variable x with 0. F of 0 means what, sir? Replace the independent variable x with 0. So f of 0 is equal to 0 plus 1 divided by 0 square minus 3 into 0 minus 4. 1 divided by minus 4. So corresponding to this input 0, what is the output we have? Minus 1 by 4. Next, f of 1 is equal to 1 plus 1 divided by 1 square minus 3 into 1 minus 4. 2 divided by 1 minus 3 minus 4. 2 divided by minus 6. Minus 1 by 3. F of minus 1, minus 1 plus 1 divided by minus 1 whole square minus 3 into minus 1 minus 4. This is 0 divided by 1 plus 3 minus 4, 0 by 0, undefined. So you must be very careful for the value of x at which the function is not defined. So when taking x equal to minus 1, output you are getting 0 by 0. So the function is not defined when x equal to minus 1. Here we are interested to calculate only those values of x for which the function is defined. That is called a domain. Right? This is the first example we have on functions. Let's see the second question. F of x is equal to x square minus 5, comma f of root 5 is equal to question mark. F of x is equal to x square minus 5. F of root 5 is question mark. F of root 5 is equal to root 5 whole square minus 5. 5 minus 5 is 0. So function value is 0. It means for the input root 5, output is equal to 0. Next, f of x is equal to 5 to the power of x plus 1 by 5 to the power of x minus 1. Then f of x is option A, an even function. Option B, an odd function. Option C, a composite function. Option D, none of this. Option D, none of this. Now look at the solution, sir. A function is said to be an even function when f of minus x is equal to f of x. A function is said to be an even function when f of minus x is equal to f of x. A function f of x is said to be an odd function. Said to be an odd function when f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. Remember these two points. A function is said to be an even function when f of minus x is equal to f of x, and it is said to be an odd function when f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. Now, f of x is equal to 5 to the power of x plus 1 by 5 to the power of x minus 1. 5 to the power of x plus 1 by 5 to the power of x minus 1. F of minus x is equal to 5 power minus x plus 1 by 5 power minus x minus 1. So 5 to the power of minus x, we can write 1 by 5 power x plus 1. 1 by 5 power x minus 1. You can take LCM here. 1 plus 5 power x by 5 power x divided by 1 minus 5 power x by 5 power x. These two cancel. So this is 1 plus 5 power x by 1 minus 5 power x. You can take 1 minus as common in the denominator. 5 power x plus 1 divided by 5 power x minus 1. This is equal to minus f of x. This is equal to minus f of x. Therefore, f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. The given function is, an odd function. The given function is an odd function. Question number 4. F of x is equal to 3 minus x square. F of x is option A, an odd function. Option B, an even function. Option C, a periodic function. Option D, none of this. Now, f of x is equal to 3 minus x square. F of minus x is 3 minus of minus x whole square. 3 minus x square, this is f of x. This is f of x. Since f of minus x is equal to f of x, the given function is, an even function. The given function is an even function. Next question number 5. If f of x is equal to q into x minus b divided by q minus b plus b into x minus q divided by b minus q, then f of p plus f of q is equal to question mark. F of p plus f of q is question mark. No, sir. F of p, you replace the variable x with p. This is equal to q into p minus p divided by q minus p. P into p minus q divided by p minus q. plus p minus p cancel, this is 0.
0 into q is 0, 0 divided by anything is 0.
Plus p minus q cancel, leaving with p. Now f of q is equal to q into these two cancel. This is equal to q plus 0 q. This is q plus 0 q. Therefore, f of p plus f of q is equal to p plus q. This option is available for you. That option you have to select. Over. Question number 6. If f of x is equal to 2x square minus 5x plus 4, then 2 into f of x is equal to f of 2x, then x is equal to question 1, then x is equal to question 1. It means for what value of x? For what value of x? 2 times f of x is equal to f of 2x. Function is also given. So first let us calculate 2 times f of x. This is equal to 4x square minus 10x plus 8. F of 2x is equal to 2 into 2x whole square minus 5 into 2x plus 4. This is 2 into 4x square minus 5 2s are 10x plus 4. This is 8x square minus 10x plus 4. This is 8x square minus 10x plus 4. Given 2 times f of x is equal to f of 2x. What is given in the question? 2 times f of x is equal to f of 2x. 4x square minus 10x plus 8 is equal to 8x square minus 10x plus 4. Minus 10x minus 10x cancel. Take 4x square to the right hand side. Bring 4 to the left hand side. 8 minus 4 is equal to 8x square minus 4x square. 4 is equal to 4x square. X square is equal to 1. X is equal to plus or minus 1. X is equal to plus or minus 1 is the answer to the given question. Now, f of x is equal to log x, comma, x greater than 0. Then,
f of p plus f of q plus f of r is equal to question mark. F of p plus f of q plus f of r is question mark. So first let us replace the variable x with the p. F of p is equal to log p. When I replace the variable x with the q, this is log q. F of r is equal to log r. Now f of p plus f of q plus f of r is equal to log p plus log q plus log r. This is equal to log p q r. Log is a function, sir. You can write it as f of p q r. Log is a function, so you can replace that one with f. So it is a log p q r, it is f of p q r. If f of x is equal to 2x square minus 5x plus 2, then okay sir, first let us calculate f of 4 plus h. 2 into 4 plus h whole square minus 5 into 4 plus h plus 2. So a plus b whole square, a square plus 2ab plus b square plus 2. So when I open the brackets, so 32 plus 16h plus 2h square minus 20 minus 5h plus 2. 32 plus 2 is 34 minus 20 plus 16h minus 5h plus 2h square. So this is equal to 40 plus 11h plus 2h square. This is f of 4 plus h. Now f of 4. This is 2 into 4 square minus 5 into 4 plus 2. 16 2s are 32, 20 plus 2. 34 minus 20, this is 14. F of 4 plus h minus f of 4. This is 40 plus 11h plus 2h square minus 14. 2h square plus 11h, let me take h as common, 2h plus 11, take h this side, 4 plus h minus f of 4 by h is equal to 2h plus 11. So what is your final answer? 2h plus 11, that is the answer to the given question. Y is equal to h of x. This is px minus q divided by qx minus p. Px minus q by qx minus p, h is equal to. Then x is equal to. Now look at the question, sir. what is given in the question? Y is written in terms of x. Y is written in terms of x. So what is asking? Can we write x also in terms of y? That is the meaning of this question. Y is written in terms of x as px minus q by qx minus p. Can we write y x also in terms of y? So let us see, sir. Y is equal to px minus q divided by cross multiply. Q into yx minus py is equal to px minus q. Qyx minus px is equal to py minus q. Taking this minus py to the right hand side, taking minus py to the right hand side and bringing minus q to the left, plus px to the left hand side. From these two, I can take x as common. Is equal to py minus q. X is equal to py minus q divided by qy minus p. X is written in terms of y. Look at these two. These two are same except the variable x is replaced with y. Look at these two. This one and this one. Both are one and the same. The only difference is variable x is replaced with y. So you can write this as h of y. Y is equal to hx. So h is equal to h1. X is equal to h1. Now look at the next question. Y is equal to, f of x is equal to x square minus x. Then f of h plus 1 is question mark. F of h plus 1 is question mark. So you have to replace x with h plus 1. Okay, when the variable is x, this is the function. When the variable is h plus 1, how it can be written? That is what this is basically stands for. So f of h plus 1, this is h plus 1 whole square minus h plus 1. So this is h square plus 2h plus 1 minus h minus 1. Plus 1 minus 1 cancel. H square plus 2h. Minus h. This is equal to h square plus h. So you can also write this as minus h whole square minus of minus h. This value also I want to write in this format. Okay. Now, here x is the variable, then f of x is x square minus x. Here what is the variable? Minus h is the variable. Minus h is the variable here. So it can be written as f of minus h. This is written as f of minus h. Here minus h is the variable. Okay. Look at the 11th question. F of x is equal to
1 minus x divided by 1 plus x. Then f of 1 by x is equal to question mark. F of 1 by x is question mark. Okay. This can also be written as f circle f of 1 by x. A composite function. F circle f. Now let us see the way of solving this question. First you replace x with 1 by x. First you replace x with 1 by x. F of 1 by x is equal to 1 minus 1 by x divided by 1 plus 1 by x. When I replace x with 1 by x, I'll get 1 minus 1 by x by 1 plus 1 by x. X minus 1 by x plus 1. Now, f of 1 by x. This is f of x minus 1 by x plus 1. X minus 1 by x plus 1. It means in the given function, x is replaced with x minus 1 by x plus 1. So, f of x minus 1 by x plus 1, this is equal to 1 minus x minus 1 by x plus 1, 1 plus x minus 1 by x plus 1. X plus 1 minus x plus 1 divided by x plus 1. X plus 1 plus x minus 1 divided by x plus 1. Sorry. Plus x minus x cancel, plus 1 minus 1 cancel. 2 divided by 2x. This is equal to 1 by x. What is the answer to this question? 1 by x. Now let's see the next question. F of x is equal to x square plus 3x plus 1. G of x is equal to 2x minus 3. Then f circle g of x is question. Very simple, sir. F circle g of x is equal to f of g of x. First of all, how to write f circle g? It is written as f of within the brackets g of x. What is g of x, sir? 2x minus 3. Now look at this. In the function f, x is replaced. You have to replace x with 2x minus 3. F of x is given in that you replace x with 2x minus 3. So this is 2x minus 3 whole square plus 3 into 2x minus 3 plus 1. 4x square minus 12x plus 9 plus 6x minus 9 plus 1. 4x square plus minus 12x plus 6x means minus 6x plus 1. So f of 2x minus 3 is equal to 4x square minus 6x plus 1. Next. F of x is equal to 2 power x. Then f of x plus y is equal to question mark. F of x plus y is equal to question mark. Now sir, f of x plus y is equal to 2 power x plus y. Just to replace x with y. Sorry, x with x plus y. This is a power x plus y, which can be written as a power x into a power y. Let us see how the options are given. So this is f of x and it is f. This way options are given. Therefore, f of x plus y is equal to f of x into f of y. Next question. F of x is equal to 2x plus 3. Then the value of f of 2x minus 2 times f of x plus 3 is equal to is. F of x is equal to 2x plus 3. F of 2x, 2 into 2x plus 3, this is 4x plus 3, 2 times f of x, 2 into 2x plus 3, so 4x plus 6, therefore f of 2x minus 2 times f of x plus 3, f of 2x is nothing but a 4x plus 3, minus 4x minus 6 plus 3, plus 3 minus 3, sorry, plus 3 plus 3 plus 6 minus 6 cancel, this is 0. Next question. F of x is equal to x square plus x minus 1. Then 4 into f of x is equal to 4 into f of x is f of 2x. Then x is equal to question mark. Then x is equal to question. So consider 4 into f of x. This is f of 2x. 4 into f of x is 2x. Now 4 times x square plus x minus 1 is equal to f of 2x, means you have to replace x with 2x in the given function, plus 2x minus 1. So this is 4x square plus 4x minus 4. 4x square, 4x square cancel. Bring 2x to this side, take minus 4 to this side. 4x minus 2x is minus 1 plus 4. 2x is equal to 3, x is equal to 3 by 2. X is equal to 3 by 2. Now let us see one more question. F of 5 is question. Now replace x with 5, sir. 5 square minus 25 by 5 minus pi. 25 minus 25 by 5 minus pi. 0 divided by 0, undefined. So the function is not defined. The function is not defined when x is equal to 5. Next question. F of x is equal to log 1 plus x by 1 minus x. Then f of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. 2x divided by 1 plus x square is question mark. Now sir, replace x with 2x divided by 1 plus x square. 2x divided by 1 plus x square. This is equal to log 1 plus 2x by 1 plus x square. So this is equal to log x square plus 2x plus 1 divided by x plus 1 whole square. Sorry, 1 plus x square divided by x square plus 1 minus 2x divided by x square plus 1. These two cancel. Now this is of the type log a square plus 2ab plus b square. A square plus 2ab plus b square is a plus b whole square. So x plus 1 whole square. Look at the denominator. A square minus 2ab plus b square. A square minus 2ab plus b square. So this is x minus 1 whole square. So this is a log x plus 1 by x minus 1 whole square. 2 into log. Now, before writing this step, now sir, this can also be written as log 1 plus x whole square by a plus a minus b whole square or b minus a whole square, one and the same. So you can write 1 minus x whole square. Now it is log 1 plus x by 1 minus x whole square. 2 times log 1 plus x by 1 minus x. Log 1 plus x by 1 minus x is nothing but f of x. So this is equal to 2 times f of x. This is 2 times f of x.
Next question. If f of x minus 1 is equal to x square minus 4x plus 8, f of x minus 1 is equal to x square minus 4x plus 8, then f of x plus 1 is equal to question mark. F of x plus 1 is equal to question mark. Okay. Now what is required here? For what value of x? I'll get f of x plus 1. It means what value I have to put for x so that I'll get f of x plus 1 inside the brackets. So look at this one. When x is equal to x plus 2. When I say x is equal to x plus 2, if I replace x with x plus 2 minus 1, it will be x plus 1. F of x plus 1 is equal to x plus 2 whole square minus 4 into x plus 2 plus 8. X square plus 4x plus 4 minus 4x minus 8 plus 8. This is x square plus 4. F of x plus 1 is equal to x square plus 4. Okay, sir. That's all in this. Remaining in the next session. Thank you.